Here we have three inputs, x, y, and z, and a bias input that is always 1. And we want to find the equation of a plane that separates the zeros and the ones. And given that this is the equation of a plane, so we start by randomly initializing the weights. In this case, the weights are W0, W1, W2, and W3. And then we go into a loop where we first calculate the weighted sum. So WS is equal to W0 plus W1 times X plus W2 times Y plus W3 times Z. And second, we apply an activation function. And this in this case, we have a step function. So if WS is bigger than the threshold of the step function, then the result will be 1 and it will be 0 otherwise. And third, we determine the error, and the error will be the target result minus the result. And fourth, we adjust the weights. So W1 will be equal to the learning rate times the error times X plus the original W1, and W2 will be equal to the learning rate times the error times Y plus the original W2, and same thing for W3. And the learning rate here is the rate at which the neural network learns, and it ranges from 0 to 1. And we repeat steps 1 through 4 for all vectors in the training data, for all those vectors. And this is one epoch, which is one path through all training vectors. And then we outer loop through additional epochs until the error is equal to 0 for all training vectors in the final epoch. And the objective is to determine what weights W0, W1, W2, and W3 would lead to the target result equaling to the result for all vectors in the training data. So what we do is we set WS is equal to the threshold. So W0 plus W1 times X plus W2 times Y plus W3 times Z is equal to the threshold, which gives us this equation. And since the equation of a plane is AX plus BY plus CZ plus D is equal to 0, this means that A is equal to W1, and B is equal to W2, and C is equal to W3, and D is equal to W0 minus the threshold. This is a pre-built version of the application. So if we go ahead and run it, we went from epoch 0 to epoch 3, and we discovered this plane equation that separates 4 points in 3-dimensional space, x, y, and z. So x0 here is the bias, which is always 1. And we discovered w0 equal 0.19, and W1 equals 0.53, W2 equals 0.54, and W3 equals 0.28. And the target result equal to the result for all 4 vectors. And we started in epoch 0 with the target result different from the result in 2 vectors.
Next, I went ahead and created a new project with two classes, a driver class with a main method and a perceptron class. And the code here will be the same as in the previous tutorial. The difference is that we have a bias here that is always 1 and 4 points in a 3-dimensional space. And this is the target result for each one of those points. And this is W0, this is W1, W2, and W3. Now, going to the driver class, we'll have two utility methods. A print heading method that will print the heading for each one of the epochs, and a print vector method that will print the data below the heading. So I will start here by picking up the training data, and in main, let's go ahead and pick up the initial weights, and I will instantiate a driver and a perceptron, and we will start from epoch number 0. And I will define an error flag, a boolean error flag, and I will start it with true and an error and start it as 0. And let's define the adjusted weight array, and we'll go into a while loop while the error flag is true. We will print the heading for the epoch, and we will go into a for loop to print the data below the heading. So for each one of the vectors in the data, we'll first pick up the weighted sum by calling calculate weighted sum on the perceptron instance. And then we will pick up the result by applying the activation function to the weighted sum that we picked up here. So perceptron.apply activation function. And before the for loop, we will reinitialize the error flag and the error for each one of the epochs. So this will be set initially to false and the error to 0. And in the for loop, we will pick up the error for this specific vector in the for loop. So the error will be the target result minus result. And if we have an error, then we set the error flag to true so that we stay in the while loop. And then we will pick up the adjusted weights. So we'll call perceptron.adjustWeights. And we will print this vector and set the weights to the adjusted weights array that we picked up over here. And after finishing, we'll print out the plain equation. So W1 X1 and W2 times Y and W3 times Z and W0 times 1, which is W0 minus the threshold, minus perceptron dot threshold, and this will equal to 0. And finally, let's go ahead and test run the application. So we went from epoch 0, where the target result is different than the result in those two vectors. We went to epoch 2, and the target result is equal to the result in all vectors. And this is the plane equation that we discovered that separates the ones from the zeros in a three-dimensional space. So the discovered W0 is 0.48, W1 0.14, W2 0.22, and W3 0.57.